Next, I'm going to talk about the hotel industry, and the general perspective in the hotel industry is pretty much the same thing as airline industry. They like to maintain the profitability, and they like to lower their operating costs, and they care about the customer loyalty. Their asset is really effective. They want their asset to be effective, and they like to open in new markets because many of the hotel industries are not yet in international, like different countries. So if they do, they will generate higher income. For example, we found recent news. We found I found that Hyatt has the experts look at the Hyatt as the best company to invest in because it has the potential growth in the future because it has more room to franchise their rooms to operate more income. So that's one thing to keep in mind. And a little bit of background on the hotel industry. They are a vibrant industry with many acquisitions and sales. Market changes at a faster rate compared to the other two industries. And hotels are consolidating to minimize their operating costs. Now I'm going to start with the ratios. In looking at this chart, Hilton has the highest number on the current and quick ratios, but Hyatt has the highest cash ratio, meaning Hyatt has more cash than the other companies to cover the debt, short-term debt, but Hilton has higher level of inventory and receivables compared to the other companies to cover the short-term debt. Long-term debt, I will start with the total debt ratio. I like the Hyatt best in this case because it has the lowest debt ratio and it also has lowest debt to equity ratios. Looking at the chart, you can see Intercontinental and Kimpton has same numbers. It's because Intercontinental purchased Kimpton and now they are basically the same companies, but they are operating still as Kimpton. So keep that in mind because it's gonna be the same numbers overall, and I will not mention about Kimpton. I'll just go with Intercontinental if I have to choose that. Next one, I like Intercontinental better on the TIE because it has the highest number. And cash coverage, I like the Hyatt better than Intercontinental, even though Intercontinental has higher number because Hyatt is more stable compared to Intercontinental. Intercontinental has been like numbers has been decreasing over the years, so I will go with Hyatt in this case. Now I'll talk about the profitability and asset efficiency. Intercontinental has the highest profit margin, and Marriott is doing the best in their asset efficiency. Return on equity, the most important part of the investment. In this case, even though Hilton has a little bit higher number than Hyatt, I like the Hyatt better because over the time Hilton's number has been decreasing and Hyatt has been increasing, so I like the Hyatt better. Marriott has a really, really high number, but the other information in the past is not available. And also, equity multiplier of 2016, look at the Marriott, has 17. So I think that high number is driven by debt, not return on assets. And return on assets in this case, Intercontinental is the one who has the highest number. I'm thinking if the other ratios were available for Intercontinental might be able to win the ROE as well, but because the equity multiplier is not available here, I'll just not mention that for return on equity for Intercontinental. Looking at the market value, Hyatt has the highest PE ratio, and Marriott has the highest number on market to book, and EV multiple also Marriott wins here. Marriott has the highest number on the free cash flow. Hilton was doing good, but it's fluctuating by a lot. So Intercontinental, whereas it's increasing. So I like the Marriott the best here. And And right here, in this ratio, Hyatt is doing the best compared to the other companies. And looking at the cost of capital, Hilton has negative economic value added. And it has negative number on EVA spread, even though its return on investment capital has positive number. Hyatt's economic value added is negative, and also EVA spread is really low, negative number, and return on investment capital is positive. Intercontinental has positive economic value added, high numbers on return on investment capital, and high number on EVA spread, whereas the other two companies are not. Marriott also has positive economic value added, return on investment capital, and positive EVA spread. However, just looking at the overall news and ratios, I'll go with Hyatt in this case because it's profitable and its profit is generated by their asset. And they have the most cash compared to the other companies, and they can afford that. Even though it's not stable, they has a potential growth to earn the, a lot more profit because they have potential to go out to different countries and generate more income to grow. However, Intercontinental is already, Intercontinental had really big numbers on everything, and it looked really great, but all those were generated by debt. I mean, it is great to generate the high income with the debt, so if you are willing to take more risk, you can go with Intercontinental over Hyatt, but, and then Intercontinental is also a lot bigger than Hyatt, and I think that's why it has a higher income. So in this case, I would go with Hyatt overall. So now it's time to choose which company is the best out of those three. And looking at the all those ratios that we went over and use and their capital structures and stability, comparing those, Valero has the highest number on the short-term solvency ratios, meaning Valero is able to cover the short-term debt better than the other companies. In the long-term, however, Southwest wins over Valero. Times interest earnings, Southwest has a lot higher number on it, meaning they can cover 48 times of their debt with their income, so that's a really good sign. Cash coverage, I wasn't able to find numbers on the Southwest, so I will not talk about the cash coverage here. Profitability, Southwest has the highest profit margin by not small numbers, but big numbers, almost double as Hyatt. So I like the Southwest best, but the efficiency, I said efficiency, I like the Valero better because it has almost double numbers in Southwest. And its ROE, return on equity, I like the Southwest best because numbers are just, compared to the other company numbers are really, really high, and it's driven by return on asset, not by debt. So I like the Southwest. Market value, Hyatt just generally since like has higher market value than the other two companies. Their market to book ratio also Hyatt is better, better and EV multiple also. But cash flow, I like Southwest better because it's kept increasing over a year, and the and it has the highest ratio for cash flow. I mean, Hyatt has the highest, but it's decreasing, whereas Southwest is stable. Looking at the cost of capital, Valero, Hyatt, and Southwest. Southwest has the highest number on the highest economic value added. and its return on investment capital is also the highest, and EVA spread is also the highest. So comparing those companies, I like the Southwest the best out of those three industries because it's able to cover their debt with their earnings, and those earnings are not generated by debt, it's generated by their asset. And long-term solvency, it had the best number, and it was stable. Its capital structure had the highest economic value added and the highest numbers on return on investment capital and EVA spread. Its free cash flow was good enough, and it was profitable. Their asset efficiency wasn't better than the other, but their return on equity is coming from their return on asset. So I like the Southwest best overall. Thank you so much.